Good morning, students. How are you? Hope that you are fine. In the last class, what we have done? We have done line, ray, point, line segment, parallel lines, and intersecting line. In today's class, what will we do? Can you tell me? Just I am doodling this. What is this? Can you tell? There are the different pictures, there are the different figures you will observe. This is also a figure, this is also a figure, this is also, this one 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 is also, this whole is also. But these all, whatever I doodle on that board, whatever I doodle on that board, this is called curve. Curve. In the simple language, we can say that any figure which is formed by doodling or figures without lifting the pencil from the paper and without use a ruler, all are called curves. Is that clear? All are curved. In common language, curve means no straight line. In common language, curve means no straight line where we never use or we use we draw the without scale. In mathematics, we use these curves in our daily day-to-day life. If a curve does not cross itself, then it is called a simple curve. When a curve does not cross itself, it is called a simple curve. Suppose I have drawn this. This is a simple curve. And if I draw this like, this is called an open curve. And this is a closed curve. This is an open curve, this is a closed curve. Is that clear? I have not used any scale there. There is a no straight line. This is a closed curve, this is an open curve, this is called simple curve because it is not crossing each other. But when a so in this case, open curve and closed curve. Now if we imagine a tennis court, imagine a cricket ground, we will find that inside, outside, and on the line. Suppose I have drawn a curve. What is curve? I think you all understand. Suppose this is a curve. This is a curve and this is a closed curve. So whatever, suppose a point is inside that, this is called inside of the curve, and a point outside, that is called outside of the curve. When a cricket player hit a ball and the ball lies outside the ground, that is called outside. If the ball lies inside the boundary, and it is called, that is called inside. And if the ball touches that rope that is on the cricket ground, is called on the line. So that's in the same way, inside the curve, outside the curve, and on the curve, on the line or on the curve. Any doubt, students? What we have learned? Curve. What is curve? That is not a straight line, that is called a curve. By doodling on a, we have just, I have made some pictures, I have drawn without lifting my marker, that is called a curve. And we have discussed a simple curve, and we have discussed the closed curve and open curve. The point inside, that is known as the inside and outside, and on the boundary of the curve. And the interior of a curve together with its boundary is called the region. The interior of the curve. The interior or of a curve with its boundary is called region. Okay, there's a difference in that. It's called be area or region. Now what will we do? This video we will discuss about the polygon. What will we discuss? We will discuss about the polygon. What is the polygon? After curve, what we will learn? After curve, we will learn polygon. What do we mean by polygon? Poly. Let's go on. Can you tell what do you mean by polygon? Yes. A closed curve, a simple curve that is made from the length segments or sides is called a polygon. Or we may say that a closed curve, that is a simple curve that is made from ruler, is called a polygon. This triangle is an example of a polygon. This triangle is an example of a polygon. So this is called polygon. This is also called polygon. This is also called polygon. Is that clear? These all are the example of polygons, because all these figures are made up of closed. These are all figures are made up entirely with the line segment. These all figures are made up of the line segment. So it is called a polygon. You can perform a activity at your home by using the matchsticks. You can make different types of polygons. By using the matchsticks, you can use the make the different types of polygons. You can use 5 matchsticks, that is called pentagon. Using 4 matchsticks, that will be called quadrilateral. Using 3 matchsticks, that will be called a triangle. And using 2 matchsticks, that will be a not a polygon, because the figure is not closed. Now in the polygon, this is a triangle, this is a triangle, this is a quadrilateral, this is a pentagon. Now in polygon we will discuss about the sides, vertices or vertex and diagonals. What are sides? The line segment forming a polygon is called its sides. The line segment forming a polygon is called its sides. The line segment forming a polygon is called its sides. After the polygon, we talk about the vertex. What is vertex? Can tell someone? What is vertex? Yes, in your room. Oh, this is the example of a vertex. Is it the example of a vertex? Yes, you may say that this is an example of a vertex, but not the proper. In a room where the two edges are meeting each other is called a vertex. A point where this is a vertex. The meeting points of the side is called the vertex. Where the two sides meet each other, they are called the vertex. Did you get what is a vertex? The meeting point of the sides is called the vertex. After that, what is diagonal? When in a four-sided figure, in a four-sided polygon, when the opposite vertex are joined, they are called diagonal. If we talk about the sides in this figure, AB, BC, CD and DA are sides. AB, BC, CD and DA are called sides. And what are vertex? What are vertex? A, B, C and D are the vertex. What are diagonals?
What are diagonals?
What are diagonals? When the two vertex are joined, AC and BD are the diagonals. AC and BD are the diagonals. Is that clear, students? Now, after that, what will we learn? We will learn about the adjacents, sides. What are adjacent sides? Can you tell me about the adjacent sides? Adjacent adjacent sides. Can you tell me the adjacent sides? What do you mean by adjacent? Suppose the 6th A class. In 6th A or even in 5th A, there was a class, another class inside of your class, that is called the adjacent class. 5th A and 5th B are together, so they are adjacent to each other. There is a neighboring house of you, there is a house near of your house that has some common wall, that is called the adjacent. Here, what is adjacent? AB is adjacent to BC. AB is adjacent to BC because they have a common vertex. They have a common vertex. So AB adjacent to BC. BC adjacent to CD. CD adjacent to AD. And AD adjacent to BA. These are the example of adjacents. AB adjacent to BC. BC adjacent to CD. CD adjacent to DA. And DA adjacent to AB. Any doubts, friends? What do you mean by adjacent? AB, BC, BC, CD, CD, AD or DA or AD, BA. That's not a big problem. AB or BA both are same. That's not a big problem. You can write it as a DA also. CD, DA and DA, AB. That's not a big problem. So students, what we have learned in today's class? We have learned about the curve. We have learned about the polygon. We have learned about the sides of a polygon. We have learned about the vertex. We have learned about the diagonals. We have learned about the adjacent sides. Same way what we have done. Adjacent vertex A adjacent to B, B adjacent to C, C adjacent to D and D adjacent to A. So we have discussed the adjacent and we have also discussed the diagonals. We have also discussed the diagonals. So students, this is the whatever the basic required for that exercise, that is exercise 4.2. If you have any doubt, any confusion, then you can discuss me, you can call me, you can contact me. Is that clear? No need to note it down. You have to do your work. I will send you the NCERT book PDF. Now students, comes to this. Now we will do the exercise 4.2. Question number first. Classify the following curves as open and closed. Classify the curve as the open and closed. The first one, A1. A is the, what are the open curves? Yes, A and C are the open. And what are the closed? Closed curve, students. Yes. B and E are the closed curve. Observe the diagram carefully. A and C are open. B, D, E are closed. Second one is a draw rough diagrams to illustrate the example of open and closed curve. Now attempt yourself. Attempt second question yourself. You have to give an example of open and closed curve. Next one is draw any polygon and shades its interior. You have to draw any polygon just like this is a polygon. Okay, and you have to shade the portion. This is your third question, students. What was the first? You have to classify the open and closed. What was the second? You have to draw the diagram of open and closed. What was the third? You have to draw any polygon and draw it shades, draw its interior. Next one is the fourth. Consider the given figure and answer the question. This figure is given. Just consider this figure. Is it a curve? Yes. Is it a curve? Yes, it is a curve. And is it a closed curve? The A part, yes, it is a curve. B, yes, it is a closed curve. This diagram is given to you, students. This diagram is given to you. And you have been asked to whether it is a curve? Yes. And is it a closed curve? Yes. Next one is question number 5. Illustrate if possible each of the following with a rough diagram. A closed curve with not a polygon. Can you draw a closed curve? You have to draw a closed curve but not a polygon. So how will you draw? This is a closed curve and that is not a polygon. Is that clear? Closed curve, that is not a polygon. An open curve that is made up of entirely of segment. Open curve that is made up of segments. An open curve that is made up of segments. Is that clear, students? The next one is what? A closed polygon. A polygon with two sides. Can you draw a polygon with two sides? Can you draw? No. It is not possible to draw a polygon with two sides. Any doubts regarding these 5 questions? Have you any problem, confusion regarding curve, open curve, polygon, closed polygon, vertex, shaded portion, interior, exterior, diagonal, sides, vertex, vertices? Any doubt, any confusion you can ask. This is your exercise 4.2. What you have to do, you have to do it again. Nothing you have to do new. You have to just attempt these all questions again. And you have to show this work to me. Is that clear? And subscribe our channel. And best of luck for the next exercise which will start from tomorrow, not today. Okay, students? Thanks students for watching this video. Like, comment, share, subscribe as your wish. Is that clear? Best of luck, students. Best of luck and thanks a lot.